So actually, I wanted to end the day introducing yet another new inductee into the Oryx Founders Club. Now, I don't know about you, I know everybody appreciates it's the special moment. It's their day in the limelight. It's their chance to go into a new organization that's never been offered in direct selling. I don't think of any of that. I always think about this. Geez, just think about these people for the rest of their life and their kids and their grandkids. Every time a dividend check goes out from Oryx, they get a paycheck forever. Must be nice. If you'll think about that when you look at them, I promise they'll be better looking. Now, this last person, you're going to notice a theme here. I doubt that she even remembers what she used to think of me. I know, it's like a common theme, Tim and now her, right? I'm like mold. I grow on you after a while. But when we first knew each other, she'll lie her butt off. She'll say, oh, I always liked you. Liar! I don't know where she got it, but she thought I was loud. She thought I was obnoxious. She thought I was an idiot. And worse than that, she really thought I was a bad speaker. I was inappropriate on stage, which I still am. I didn't dress well. I wasn't her style. And the person I have to thank for our friendship today is Mark Wilson. It's true, Mark Wilson. Because one day Mark went up to her and he said, listen, you are working your guts off in this business. She is talking to everybody she knows and she had no clue about the compensation plan. You need to talk to Fred and learn how to do it. So to speak to her credit, notwithstanding I wasn't her favorite, she called me up. I'd like to talk to you about the compensation plan and what I'm doing wrong. We talked. And I'm telling you, overnight, this woman changed from not knowing the compensation plan to knowing the compensation plan better than most people ever will in our former company. She knew it so well, she advanced from top 30, top 40 in the entire company to top 25, to top 20, to top 15. I believe she got inside the top 10. Of all of the companies. And she was the toast of the town because no one had jumped so quickly, so fast in all of those ranks. From that moment on, we have been close personal friends. She likes me. And friends at my age are hard to find and a little harder to keep. And now, when we left, she was one of the first people, one of the first, to call and hear our side of the story rather than the propaganda that was told to her. As a result of that phone call that she did not organize, she was terminated immediately from that company. It's a lot of money to lose overnight. Most people would collapse. Most people would fall down and die, cry, give up, beg, plead. In fact, the company went back and said, if you will swear undying allegiance to us, think about it. You can have your money back. And we're not talking 100,000 bucks here, folks. We're not talking 200,000 a year. We're not talking $400,000 a year. We're not talking $500,000 a year. Think about standing on your principles, making that much money, and basically telling that company, I'll just leave. That's a pretty impressive person to me. Pretty impressive. So now she's all in. She's here with us, and now as being a new inductee into the Founders Club, we're gonna be friends for a lot, lot longer. Yeah. Let's watch her story.
My Story.
Yes!
I came from a place of knowing that, you know, you grow up and you get married and you get the white picket fence and, you know, the knight in shining armor that was going to take me away and all that. And so I got married when I was 19, had two daughters, and then found myself as a single mom raising two kids. And I raised them for 18 years by myself, and they were in daycare for their entire childhood. I worked two jobs, three jobs, and was on government assistance. I was on food stamps, and so I know what it feels like to not have. And my kids, they didn't get the best of me as a mom, and I did the best I could. They got the best I had. And I'm trying to figure out what I'm gonna do with the rest of my life. Like, how does anybody stop working? If you don't work, you don't get paid. How do I stop? How do I eat? What do I do for my future? And that's when I was introduced to network marketing. I led with products. I shared products with people because I wanted to bless them. I wanted to help people because every time somebody thanked me, I felt good here, and it fulfilled a whole lot of things for me. But it also was giving me a nice part-time income, and I felt like I had died and gone to heaven. I knew that this is how I could create the life that I knew that I was born to live. So all of a sudden, I allowed myself to open my mind to the possibilities of how it would feel to wake up every day and not have my life dictated by time or money or the lack of either, and do exactly what feels good right here. And it's like the person I always knew that I was has come out, and I found my voice, and I figured out that the best way to predict my future was to create it. I wrote it all out and said, this is the life that I will now have. And so when I went out and talked to people and they said, no, that's not for me, I'm not interested, I'd say, it's fine, you know, 2 years from now, this is where I'm gonna be. And the train is moving with or without you, so you can hop on or get out of the way. I get a phone call, and it was so amazing because I was actually on a conference call, doing a three-way call for one of my team members. And all of a sudden, my phone is beeping, and I'm looking, and I see Fred Cooper is calling me. I call Fred, and I said, what's happened? What's the matter? And Fred says to me, Lynn, you know how you always call me partner, and you've always called me partner? And I said, yes. He said, well, now you are able to call everybody in here partners for life because you are in the Founders Club. I was like, wow, and I just bawled. I was crying, and they were screaming. And the fact that I am now a founder and that I leave a legacy for my children and my children's children for generations fills me and makes me feel like, you know, as happy as I could ever be that they will be taken care of. I love my mom so much, and she's now 90 years old. She had six kids. She raised six kids on her own, and now it's my turn to give back, my turn to take care of her. And so we were able to move her over here to the beach close to where we are. The fact that the money is there to be able to put her in the finest facility in the state, it's just amazing to light up her face. And every night I call her to say goodnight to her, and she tells me how much she loves me, and it's a blessing. There are so many people who I just love that are on my team, and I wouldn't know them if it wasn't for this. I met them through this industry, and to be able to be a part of their journey, to watch them grow as people, and to know that I played even this much of a role in watching them transform themselves and claim their lives and live their best life, it fills me to do that.
You know, as a leader, you always have to be there, and Lynn is always there for everyone she works with.
It's true leverage when you do the work once and you get paid for a lifetime. So I am passionate about this industry because an ordinary person like myself, who came from nowhere, no education, started at age 50, have created total abundance and freedom in my life.
She will always embrace the room. And I think that is such a special gift. Not everybody gets in front of the room and just really gets to your heart. And Lynn just has that amazing special quality.
You know, for all the people who said to me, Lynn, this will never work. You know, you should get a real job. You'll never make it in this. They're the same people who are commuting back and forth to dead-end jobs that don't fulfill them. They can less than what they're worth and don't have time to spend with their family, their friends, or even themselves. And I live at the beach and spend time with my grandkids and my mom and my husband and walk on the beach and watch the sunrise and watch the sunsets and do exactly what I want to do every single day when I make up, because I made the choice that network marketing was my vehicle to freedom.
And the thing about Lynn is that she makes you believe in yourself when you didn't believe in yourself, because Lynn believes in you.
Don't get me wrong, I work, and I work really hard. But when you're living your passion, it doesn't feel like work.
She is so passionate about this business, passionate for helping other people.
Where Lynn, to me, is so special is that she believes so much deep down, and she will bring out the best in you.
Lynn is such a great example of what we all want to emulate.
I'm on a mission to build a powerful team to move RX forward, to really get this product and this company out there. I mean, we're fairly new here. So I'm doing my part. Maybe that's why I'm a partner. I'm all in for this. It's awesome. You want it, you go after it, you do it, you work hard, you make it happen, and then you look back and you celebrate the victories and all the people you brought with you, and it's the greatest gift.
Founders Club!
The life that she had as a result of the choices that I made. And network marketing has been the biggest gift. It's blessed my life so abundantly in so many ways. And as I look back over the years and I think about where I came from, you know, dead broke, you saw it on the video. I started when I was 50 years old. That's when my journey began in network marketing. That's when I figured out that I had to do something different, because what I was doing was trading my time for dollars, and I was getting older and I had nothing. And so embracing this industry and going on this journey and meeting Fred, and he was right, I didn't like him too good. I like Mark better because I can understand Fred's jokes, and I really thought he was kind of weird actually, you know. But during my journey with my previous company, I was so blessed by the relationships that I had with Mark and with Fred and with some of the other partners as well. So that when it came time for RX, when I found out that they had left and were coming over to start another company, when I knew that they were gone, I knew that something was going to change for me, because business for me is about relationships. It's about the people. And my business, my heart, was where it was because of those two gentlemen, because of Mark and because of Fred. So without them, I felt empty immediately, and I still remember the text that I sent to Fred. I remember it verbatim, what I said when I found out that they were going to be leaving. And I went and I looked, and it was the first time in my life where money and integrity crossed for me. And it was so interesting because I've never had any money. I've been broke my entire life. I mean, on food stamps, raising kids, single mom, never had anything. And, you know, at 50, I changed my direction. All of a sudden, I'm working hard. I'm blessing a lot of people. All of a sudden, my income is way up there. I'm making huge six-figure incomes. And the people that I'm connected with, the relationships that I have, all of a sudden are ended, and they're over here. And I'm caught in a place of making a decision as to what I am going to do with the rest of my life. And my husband says to me, "Lynn, just so you know, whatever you do, I'm behind you. Just don't risk our income." That was my advice from my husband. Just don't risk our income. I said, "Phil, the decision that I'm about to make positively is gonna risk our income." So I heard everybody talk earlier today about the very first event. That was 3 years ago today, with 25 people in Las Vegas, and I was sitting in that room. I was at that event. There's other people in this room that were at that event, and it was life-changing for me. And I want you to know that being with RX for me is the absolute best decision I have ever made in my entire life, regardless of the money. I spent 14 years with a nutrition company and didn't even know what health was until I came to RX. I had no idea. I mean, I thought I was doing pretty good, and I've heard the stories today, but I'm almost 5'3" and I weighed over 200 pounds, and I thought I was healthy. You know, I really did. I thought, well, you know, you're over 60, that's just what happens. You get fat when you get older, the doctor says your metabolism stops, you know, and that's what I got. And then I join RX and I get this call from Deanna. And it was really interesting because she was the only person I really didn't know. And they were introducing the Slenderized line. And Deanna calls me and says, "Lynn, we're starting we have a new product. We're gonna do a beta test for this product. And I was thinking maybe it would be something that you would be interested in doing." And I said, "Well, what kind of a product is it?" She said, "Well, it's a weight loss product." And I was just giving her grief because I know how hard that must have been for her. So I said, "Well, is there any particular reason you called me?" And she was like, no, nothing, you know. I get it, okay. So anyway, I got on the product, transformed my health. Transformed my health. And it's been the most amazing experience for me. And I'm not there yet. I'm still a work in progress. I have more weight to lose. But I know for the very first time in my life that health is true wealth. That is what matters most. It is about being good in your own body. It's about getting off the drugs. It's about doing your very best to take care of this gift that God gave us. And it's something that I had never done. I thought hot dogs and mac and cheese were healthy because that's what I grew up on. I didn't know what vegan was. I've never eaten a raw vegetable. I mean, I could spend the day talking about that. My point is, for the first time in my life, and I am now, this year, I'm 67, and I feel better than I ever have in my entire life. And I want to thank Rx for that. I want to thank Deanna, Dr. Strand, everybody. I just want to thank you for the gift of my health. Because I have a lot to do. I have a lot more to say. I have lives to change. And something Marla said earlier really touched me when she said, how do you know what we know? How do you hear this and not go out there and share it with others? How do you not bless other people who are struggling with their health and eating poorly and not taking the supplements that they need and they're overweight and you see this? How do we have this in our hands and not share it? I feel a responsibility to do this. It doesn't even feel like work to me. And I felt, just so you know, from the day that I joined Rx, I felt like a partner. I didn't even know what Founders Club was. I know that I felt like a partner. And I know so many people in this room feel that way. Like we're all in this together. We're all here together. You know, my mother, she was 90 when she passed. And for the last 2-3 years of her life, she was on all of the Rx products. And every day when she would take them, she would say to me, those nurses keep coming in and bringing me these little paper cups full of vitamins. And I just tell them, well, my daughter makes me take these because they keep me healthy. And they would say, oh my gosh, she is so good. Her blood pressure is good, her cholesterol, everything is good. She was just doing amazing. And she ended up having a fall and she broke her hip and, you know, that's what happened. It was kind of the beginning of the end. She had dementia, she had a lot of issues. But she lived an awesome, awesome, vibrant life. And as I was thinking about talking today, I was thinking about what Rx means to me and what being, you know, what I have been blessed with, other than the health aspect. The financial aspect of this has been so powerful for me. And I thought all along that money would be my freedom, that that's what I was looking for because I've never had any. And so I've taken that money and I've been able to put my grandchildren in private schools. They are getting incredible education that they wouldn't get otherwise. And my mother got to live the last almost 6 years of her life in the finest, finest place on the planet. And I remember when we were looking at assisted living places to put her, and we were driving around, and when we went into this place called Emeritus, which is where she lived, she said, oh my gosh, this one feels like home. And it was beautiful. It was absolutely the most expensive place in all of Florida. And she said, can I afford this one? Because I don't want you guys having to pay anything. I said, Mama, you can afford it. you have enough for this. And she was so happy, and she never knew that she wasn't paying for this with her insurance, you know, with her Medicare. She always thought that she was independent and she was on her own. And the gift that I gave her was the ability to be able to live her life in a place where she felt safe, special, loved, and it was just beautiful. You saw it on the picture there. And so the idea that financially I could do that for her made me so happy. But the realization that I had very recently after she fell was that what I've been fighting for isn't just the money, it's about the time. So many people, they make lots of money, but they don't have time with their family, with their friends, even with themselves, because they're working so many hours. They are so busy that there is no time. And when my mom fell, I was there every single day, at the hospital for 10 days, every day, visiting, being with her, loving on her, making her know that I was there. And then she was in rehab, and I was there every single day, helping to encourage her, helping to push her, to let her know that I was there. And up until the time that she died, I was with her. My brother Mike is sitting here. He's here with me today to support me. He was with her. We had the opportunity to do that. And the reality came to me after she passed. I thought about this and I thought, what if I had a job? What if I was working for somebody else and they wouldn't give me the time off? And they said, no, you don't have vacation, or they docked my pay, or didn't have the option to be able to do that. Then it hit me that it is the time. I will never, ever feel more blessed than the fact that I was there when my mom passed, that I spent the last... I spent the last month of her life with her, talking to her, being with her. That is a gift because I chose to join RX and to fight for my future and the freedom to live my life on my terms. I want each of you to think about that in your lives. I want you to think about what you give up when you can't live your life on your terms. You're here in this room and it's so exciting and there's been amazing things shared here today. And it's really great to be caught up in all of this. But when you leave here is when it starts. That's when you've got to take everything that's filled you here. You've got to take it home with you. And you've got to decide to put the pedal to the metal and fight for your futures. You've got to do that. All in is the word that I heard John McCarty say. I am 100% all in. I've been all in since the day I started. And when I saw those geese, and when one geese goes down, this past couple of weeks for me has been the first time that I can remember where I felt like I wasn't the lead one. Because I've been down, and so many amazing people in this room, my RX family and friends, have been the ones that swooped down to get me, that have come down to bless me, to encourage me, to show me love, and to pull me back up. And I wasn't even going to be at this event because my heart was just broken. And then I thought about it, and I realized that that's what partners do. You do what you gotta do. When the times are tough, when the times are easy, they're good, they're bad, they're ups, they're downs. But if you're all in, you are all in. And so I am here, and I have been the one that's been blessed by the experience of being here. And it's taught me to accept the love, to accept the gifts and the caring of so many people in this room who don't know what to say or how to say it. But I have never felt more loved ever in my life than I do since I have joined RX, and I am truly, truly honored to be a partner in this amazing company with these amazing leaderships and every single person in this room. I want you to go home, think about your lives, because you never know when you don't have your next day. Think about what's important to you, put your dreams above your fears, and don't stop just because it gets hard. You put it to the metal, like I said. You just go, and you keep going until one day you look back and you are so grateful for the journey, because you will be living the life that you were put here to live, the life on your terms. Thank you so much, everybody. God bless everybody.